Hey, so welcome back to the shop, everybody. Today I want to talk to you about something called wood movement. It's a very important topic in woodworking, and you should consider it when you're building your wood projects. So I just want to apologize up front that my thumbnail is a little goofy, but I wanted to have a little bit of fun with this video. So wood movement is something we're all gonna have to deal with in our woodworking projects because temperature and humidity is not always gonna be consistent depending on where our projects end up. I can tell you for sure that the temperature in my shop fluctuates probably 30 or 40 degrees from winter to summer, and the humidity I'm sure changes a lot as well. Most modern day cabinetry is built actually with plywood, and plywood is multiple thin sheets of wood that are glued together, laminated together in alternating directions to prevent the wood from moving very much. For ones of us that want to build things in more of a traditional manner and use solid wood for our cabinetry, we need to consider wood movement in our design. So the last project I built is the plain till cabinet, and it's built out of solid pallet wood, so I had to consider wood movement in my design. In today's video, I wanted to discuss the strategies that I employed in building this plain cabinet to hopefully prevent its self-destruction. So if you recall from the pallet wood series, I built the panels out of pallet wood, and they are edge glued together to make nice panels or large pieces of wood. The first strategy that I employed to prevent wood movement from, you know, damaging my cabinet is to alternate the grain of the individual slats of the pallets for making the panels. Each panel is made out of approximately 4 pieces of pallet wood or pallet slats. I hope you can see in the camera, but I've actually marked the grain pattern with a pencil right about there. Before I ever started building the cabinet and I started laying out the panels, I alternated the grain of each board in a different direction. And the idea behind doing that is preventing the board from wanting to cup in the same direction. What I would prefer is for when the boards begin to move, or when each individual board wants to move with humidity and temperature changes, I want them to work in different directions. That way it's not all pulling in the same direction. The second strategy that I use is I wanted the grain orientation of each panel to be in the same direction or plane. So what do I mean by that? So this panel is going to want to move with humidity and temperature changes this way. In other words, it's going to want to go in and out. It's not going to move much from top to bottom because the grain is oriented in this direction. So what I did for this cabinet is the grain is all oriented on the same plane. The outer portions of the cabinet and the shelf and the individual dividers all have the grain going in the same plane. That way, as the wood wants to move with environmental changes, it wants to move in the same direction. The last thing I wanted to happen was for the shelf or the dividers to be wanting to move in opposite directions or within a different plane than the cabinet itself. I wouldn't want those things to be fighting against each other and cause excessive forces on the cabinet. Another tactic that I used was I left a little bit of a space in between each of these panels for the plane bed. That way each one has a little bit of space to move with environmental changes. The last thing I'd want to happen is for this large plane bed panel to put a lot of pressure on the walls of my cabinet and cause it to break apart. A very savvy viewer actually asked about the box joints and if environmental changes would cause those to break. And I don't think they will. And the reason for that is that the grain is all oriented within the same plane. So environmental changes that affect this board should affect this board the same as well. So those strategies are just some of the things I considered when I was designing this cabinet. The last thing I would want is for something I've got dozens of hours in for basically breaking itself apart when I fire up the wood stove or when humidity changes within the shop. Some final advice that I'll give you is be sure the wood you're using is really dry. I didn't have any issue for this project because I used pallet wood, and this stuff is super old and very, very dry. But if I was buying material from a sawmill, I would have to wait until the moisture content was essentially equilibrated for my shop or wherever that project's gonna be. So let me know in the comment section if you think that the strategies that I employed in building this cabinet are adequate to prevent wood movement from harming the joints. And also tell me the things that you have done in the past to prevent wood movement from damaging your projects. If you're a hobby woodworker and you wanna get some strategies and tips to improve your practice, be sure to subscribe. I'm making videos at least once weekly and often twice weekly. If you'd like to be notified when I make new videos, be sure to hit that bell notification as well. As always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.